It's day number two in the big Minecraft house. And yes, it's Matt Lees from OXM, and we've popped back into our special OXM Minecraft server. I'm once again joined by Internet's last day today, unfortunately, but 2+2 is Joe. Follow him on Twitter. Hello, Joe.
Hello.
And we've done plenty of things. Well, actually, we haven't done that much. Joe's done quite a lot. Joe's made a massive spiral into the sky with a glass platform, mainly so we can keep an eye on the world and make sure that people aren't setting fire to it. Now, yeah, you'll already see quite a few changes since yesterday. We can't quite get over just how quickly this little world is tending to evolve. The castle you'll see to your right was just sort of in its early stages last time. The Panopticon, this is the brand new thing we're talking about, which is basically a fantastic tower into the sky, mainly so we can kind of uphold our police state situation. What's it been like in the crime in OXM land?
There's not been too much crime. We did have some mild arson last night, and I was murdered at one point, but otherwise we're all right.
Other than being murdered, you know, everything's fine. Yeah, it's actually been really, really peaceful and quite constructive. But yeah, you can get a really good look at the world from up here. You've increased the safety of this, actually. You've made some little barriers, haven't you?
I have. I did fall off two or three times, luckily usually landing in the sea, but this time I decided to build just a see-through wall, so we're always in view, but safe as well.
Safety comes first in OXM land. We'll go and have a good look at some of this in detail in a minute, but, you know, for 2 days' work, this is amazing. Oh, yeah, I love this. The way you get out, exit. It's quite a precision depth of hole there as well. How many times did you get that wrong?
Many. It took a huge architectural effort of dying to get that right. The sauna house, which you're about to see, was unfortunately destroyed by something. We're not sure what, and it looks like Saberwing, who I think made it, is weeping at the moment. So,
just look. Oh, I'm so sorry, Saberwing. But he does have an amazing sauna with a trapdoor, which we'll show you in a minute. Just absolutely brilliant.
It's incredible. I mean, I just sat down here for about an hour and just soaked virtually.
Good old virtual soaking. Just really let those pixels loosen up. What is this?
This is a new sort of weird treehouse. It started off as a two-story thing with a little roof garden and then just got turned into a giant waterfall house. I do fall out of this and hurt myself quite badly, but we'll get up there eventually.
Oh, lone creeper just on his own down there. And Freddy Schmidt, good old Freddy Schmidt, walking around with his Freddy Schmidt shoes. Is that sort of a kilt? I think it is. He's got a Scottish vibe.
Yeah, Freddy Schmidt followed me for a bit. I was trying to look at the tree farm, but he wouldn't let me in. That's a nice little addition to the sustainable environment policy that we're trying to get in OXM land at the moment.
Yeah, the main problem with people repeatedly coming in and setting fire to all the buildings is I think if we're not careful, we're just going to run out of wood entirely. Freddy Schmidt, good old me and our sidekick Freddy Schmidt. You might have noticed actually there's a little box there, which is just new stuff for new players, which is kind of cool. Hopefully people won't just ridiculously steal from it. It's quite a nice vibe generally. I've been quite pleased with the community we've got going on OXM land.
Yeah, we have got a nice feeling. I have to admit, I did take a stone pickaxe out of the new player box earlier, but that I am replacing it with an iron one later, so it's an upgrade.
You are fired. Get out of OXM land. OXM loo, out of order. Oh, there's a toilet. Oh! No, Freddy Schmidt, you can't come in here with this. That's naughty. Oh dear. I don't think he was aware he was being filmed at this point, but he's really lucked out. This is Freddy's claim to fame.
So I think we're heading past the OXM Wood sign here, and we've had a few extra developments. What we're coming up to now is the OXM Mine Company. On your left, you can see our new brothel, which we're not entirely happy about. We'll get to that in a minute.
I didn't realise we had a brothel. The OXM Mine Company, this is fantastic. And that is, looks like one of the best, wow, that is high-tech mine. They've got doors.
It's incredible. You go in and they've created preset mine shafts for new players to go in and mine out some stuff. This here was a portal to the fields that was ostensibly to keep evil creatures out, but it looks like they've blown it up, so it didn't really work.
Judge Nutmeg's brothel. And here we have Judge Nutmeg's. The castle has come on a long, long way. Devil Kazuya 99's castle and waterfall. I like the fact it's waterfall by Devil Kazuya 99. It's like it's a brand, like new waterfall.
Absolutely. You've got to have a big water feature if you're going to have a big castle. So I think he's done well there. I think Freddy Schmidt was helping out with the castle too. There was some collaboration going on there.
That's pretty impressive, actually. What's that up there?
I think he's called R3D. He made a sort of minimalist paradise wildlife home, but unfortunately, as you'll see in a minute, it has been slightly destroyed, and I'm not sure by what or who.
It's difficult, you see. Even though we've made a glass tower in the sky so you can watch over people and their little lives, it's still very difficult to work out when people are messing stuff up.
The main problem is being in the giant glass tower is that people might know you're watching them, but they also know that you just can't get to them in time if they're doing a crime.
It's true. I think really it's much like life. You just got to trust that people aren't going to be absolute knobs. Is this you doing a bit of repair work, or is it just...
This is just me breaking into it. Sorry, this is just me breaking into the house.
Yeah, it's a watchtower. He's getting in on it. He's really getting into the kind of police state vibe. I'm enjoying that. Is that a switch? He's made a switch.
Button-operated iron doors. It's quite... it's all mod cons in here.
So yeah, there has been a bit of vandalism, but it seems like largely that people have come together to fix it up quite quickly. And I think we've got to a sort of scale now where it's going to be a bit too much work for people to really mess it up.
Absolutely. We have reached a sort of past the early stages of man and into the Stone Age. So fire has less effect these days.
Yeah, I think it's really affected the building ethos. Wooden huts are kind of out at the moment. It is all very much about the castles, and this castle is bloody amazing. What's this?
I'm not entirely sure. There were four people working on this at one point, and then it just stopped. It was very strange.
It's mysterious.
Yeah, now you see the mysterious case of the appearing octopi. We're not sure where these came from. We think they spawned in the waterfall and then just beached, and it's quite sad, so I just look at them for a bit.
Oh, no. That's... Oh. My Little Pony in his tight red pants and iron helmet has come to vanquish the octopi. I assume to try and gain our attention and to win honour. But it's very sad watching these little octopus just drowning away on the beach.
Just their dead eyes staring at me.
Can they drown? I think octopus without water, that's drowning, isn't it?
Yeah, I think that counts as opposite drowning.
So this is inside the castle. Wow. Oh, he's got... Wow.
Incredible. Real battlements to survey all that he owns.
That's amazing. I still wonder what happened with the giant flooded water tower.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure what happened there. That seemed to be there from very early on, so that was either a very quick work or something very strange in the code.
Could have been the tower, actually. I remember Ultra Brilliant was telling me about how he'd made a tower that got filled with water. Maybe it got filled with water and then destroyed piece by piece.
That could be it. You'll see we just had a look in the portcullis there. Still no murder holes, so it's not a correct castle yet.
This is castle out of 10. It's not right. But some nice pointless flaps there. Pointless flaps, two beds, shouldn't put those things together. Oh, down the bridge, up to the main tower. This is very professional.
It's incredible. Slight Minecraft nerd point here. I'm going to look up in a second. They've got natural stone here, and I don't know how they've done it. That's like Minecraft cheats. I don't get it.
Yeah, they must have built it under a mountain or something. I don't know. Either way, that's clever.
It's very impressive. They've done it for the waterfall as well. I was, yeah, I salute you, Devil Kazuya.
Got Jazzy Boy Glee just chilling out.
He's just taken up residence. He's just standing in the room. Yeah, I don't think he belongs here.
Hey, Dazza Boy G, what you doing? This not your castle. You must leave now. You got to go.
Oh, I just want to say about this mine here. I did find some gold in it. At the risk of causing an Oregon Trail style rush, there is gold in here. If you use an iron pickaxe, you can get it.
You are not alone. I don't know if that's frightening or kind of heartwarming.
I think it's an existential lament.
Well, it's night again in OXM land. Day two has been very impressive. We've had substantially less fires and a hell of a lot of building. We're pretty proud of what you guys have made, and it's awesome. We'll keep it running for the rest of the weekend. We'll try and keep it running for the next couple of weeks. Hopefully Mojang will patch in some sort of autosave system, because at the moment we'd have to just manually press save every hour or two, which obviously is going to get quite difficult over a long period of time. But in the meantime, jump in and play. If you add us as a friend on Xbox Live, you need to add OXM space Minecraft as a friend, and we will keep it running for as long as possible. If you've enjoyed the video, then do subscribe to YouTube, and we've got plenty of other Minecraft videos available for you to have a quick look at. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.